Hey there, this is the spectacular Ihlara Valley of Cappadocia, central Turkey. Absolutely phenomenal. The fall colors you can see there. Today is October 31st. So, nearby is the town of Guzelyurt, which I found out about because I was driving along when I came to Cappadocia about a week ago, and I just saw the name of the town on a road sign that said Guzelyurt, and I was like, wow, that is a really cool name. And same thing with another city, Afyonkarahisar, that I visited earlier. Then I was just curious and intrigued, and I looked up the town and discovered that it was really cool. So that town is very close by over there, and so my plan for today was to go visit that town. And then on the way driving here, there's the azan in the background, the Muslim call to prayer. And so I was almost here, and then I saw a sign for the Ihlara Valley. And people had recommended it, but I didn't realize that it was right near Guzelyurt. And so I changed plans and came over here first, and then I'll go to Guzelyurt next. I got a late start, as usual, because I was editing videos, as is usually the case. Got to keep on the editing. And it was an hour drive here from Garame, where I'm staying in the kind of main part of Cappadocia. And so it's 3 PM, getting a little bit late, bit of a haze, a little chilly. So I'm just going to see what I can see in the time that I have here. Including going to a church. This canyon here goes for 14 kilometers, and there's a series of churches along it. And there is one close by that you can apparently go inside. So let's go see more of this spectacular area of the incredible Cappadocia. And look at that, another of the incredible cave cities of Cappadocia. Embedded into the cliffs over there. Looks phenomenal. And maybe you can get close to some of them over there. I'll do my best. I guess this is downtown Ihlara, and what a fascinating mix of old and not exactly new, but newer buildings, especially the mosque. Although it could be an older one as well. It's in very good condition, but so let's explore around and find some of these ancient cave homes and apartment complexes, and the church is a few kilometers away, so I'll drive there next. Merhaba. Good. Sorry?
Good.
Doing good. How are you? Yeah. Guzelyurt. Narlagol. Darinkuyu. I've been there. The incredible cave city. We're in the underground city of Derinkuyu. It covers 8 or 10 floors and could house like 30,000 people, and it's all underground. Here we go. All throughout this town is the old abandoned buildings, although this is not of the super old variety. Maybe 19th century or thereabouts. But then over here, you got the old stuff, the caves from thousands of years ago, unknown. Oh man, that's a funky one there. They just really don't know the whole history and when exactly people first started occupying this area and carving out the caves, but a very, very long time ago. Over there you can see the windows and maybe a door in the cliff there. There's somebody's room, house, whatever. Deep into that cliff, you can see some little holes below that one kind of bigger entryway. And you can imagine probably there was a ladder going up there. And that's how you access those rooms. This way? Okay. This guy's saying go up here for some reason, so take his advice. Maybe he's saying I'm not supposed to be there. Here we have a nice arch. Hello, merhaba. The Ihlara Valley consists of 14 kilometers along the north-south Malindi River, which runs from Salim to Ihlara Village. 16 of the valley's 105 churches are open to visitors, and most of these are within 1 kilometer of the official valley entrance. The first one you're likely to see is Agakalti Kalisi, Church Under the Trees, at the base of the stairs leading into the valley. What makes the valley unique is the ancient history of its inhabitants. The whole canyon is honeycombed with rock-cut underground dwellings and churches from the Byzantine period, built by the Cappadocian Greeks. These local people were forced to leave the area and move to Greece in the 1923 population exchange between Turkey and Greece. Due to the valley's plentiful supply of water and hidden places, this was the first settlement of the first Christians escaping from Roman soldiers. In the Ihlara Valley, there are hundreds of old churches in the volcanic rock caves. It's juice time.
Yeah, how about?
Mixed pomegranate orange.
Mix.
Okay. Yeah. And here we go into the Ihlara Valley. Thank you. the Agakalti Kalesi. I didn't realize it was going to be a cave church.
The following scenes can be seen on the walls: the Annunciation on the north half of Southern Cross Arm Vault, the Visitation and the Nativity, Coming of the Three Magi, the Fleeing of the Holy Family into Egypt, the Baptisement on the Pediment, the Death of Mary, Daniel among the Lions, the Ascension of Jesus on the Dome, Prophets and Apostles on the Rim. And so this is it. It's very small. But incredible. This might be another church here. An altar. And look what we got here, a tunnel going up into the darkness. Let's give it a try. All right. Oh, and it doesn't go to anything. Unless there was something here before, maybe probably a platform and a room on here. Just a guess, but there's got to be a reason that they went to all the trouble of digging that thing out. Had to have been something out here. Wow, what a trip. Hello, sir.
Hello.
What was your name again?
Yeah.
Your name?
Soner.
Soner?
Yeah.
I'm making a video.
Yeah.
We were talking over there.
Hello.
So you're from where in Turkey?
I am from city Artvin. Istanbul, big city.
Yes.
Small city.
Close
yeah,
to Istanbul.
Georgia.
Yes, Georgia border.
Georgia border.
Ah.
Next 3 kilometers, my life.
3 kilometers
yeah.
From Georgia border.
Yeah.
Very
Georgia
interesting.
Border.
Excellent.
Very nice mountain, very nice sea.
I see.
Very nice cathedral.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It sounds very nice. And where are you going in Turkey? Only Cappadocia or?
Cappadocia.
The whole group here?
Touristic hotel, sleeping to the Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
No. Today, the hotel.
Yeah.
After that, going to the home.
I see. Yeah. By driving?
Yeah, by bus, big bus.
Big bus all the way back to Eastern Turkey.
Yeah.
How long it takes? 12 hours?
Maybe
15 hours?
900 kilometers.
900 kilometers. Yeah. It's going to take a while.
To Turkey woman. Very, very.
Oh, yes, I see. It's all women's group.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay.
Okay. America, San Francisco, and Starlight.
Marhaba, marhaba. Nice to meet you, sir.
Nice to meet you.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. That was funny. All right, let's check out the Dark Castle Church. That sounds pretty amazing. I definitely recommend leaving more time for the Ihlara Valley. There's a lot to see here. I think I am at the Dark Castle Church. Sounds ominous. The monastery rooms were carved into a high rock mass, which is a monastery rather than just a church, so I guess it's gonna be bigger. Overlooking the valley, a passage connects the church and the chapel, and a door on the left middle part of the large hall were opened. The hall with barrel vault connects to the church on the west, and on the north to the main room, and the space that leads to kitchen, storage room, and other side spaces. So this is a big building, I guess. Unfortunately, it's gonna be hard to see. I have my cell phone, which in one of the other caves over there and in previous videos, and I used to lighten up the inside of these dark places. But there's a sign right there that says no flash. I'm sure that means also no lights from your cell phones or flashlights, and there's no other lighting in here, so that's definitely a shame. Yeah, you can't see anything. I mean, I can't see in there at all. It looks like a big space. And this is a really big one here. Wow, it's really phenomenal. It doesn't have the colorful frescoes. Big old columns here. I guess this might have been the actual church. But still, I can't see the colorful paintings. It's hard to tell if they're just worn away or something. But yeah, I'm not seeing any color here. I can see a window up there, so there might be more rooms. Like, that looks like a entryway up there. Is there like a whole network of more rooms going up there? And what is that right there? It looks like, I think that is a like wasp nest or something. And so yeah, that definitely looks like a window or a door. I guess it could be accessible by ladder as opposed to tunnels going up inside. Those two little square things below it.
or probably a spot to anchor a ladder to. Okay, there's a cave back in there, and I think I can use the flashlight here. Whoa. Nice big old room here. I'm not huge, but seems great for like a bedroom size. And then another one off here. Whoa, this one's even bigger. Whoa, and then a tunnel going up there. And here's like a shelf. Now, is that a tomb or a shelf for a living space? Seems a bit big to be just for a tomb. I would guess that people lived in here, and no obvious coffins, burial spaces there. And these are more like shelves. Whoa. And so what was that? Little storage for food or something like that. All blackened inside here. That is obviously the smoke hole. The Kokar Church. The frescoes in the church date to the end of 9th century or the second half of the 11th century. However, the date of the frescoes does not necessarily tell you the date of the cave. It could have been repainted, or it could have been originally built without the intention of being a church, and then later turned into a church. So here are the tomb sites, and some nice columns here, more tombs, and a dark area here. Can't see what's there. Looks like it might be an altar. Another arched room here. And we've got a whole big apartment complex going on here. Check this out. Go in here. Big old room here. A little tiny room in the back there. Can't see, but carved a doorway. Big open room here. And there's more, much more. Another little room in the back here again. window to your neighbor. Hey, can you pass the salt? It must go further down. The dirt is filling it in. All right, well, I think that is going to do it for the Ihlara Valley. There is more to see. I think that the trail goes further the other way, and I saw a sign that said Ihlara Town going that way, and I'm not sure if that refers to ancient town or the modern one where I was before, but you might be able to walk from town into the valley, perhaps. Either way, there is more hiking to do in this incredible natural and historical wonderland. And so, you are here. There's the first church that I went to. And then this one, the dark castle, and then I went up here. And so, that's what I saw. And here's the whole valley. And all of these churches.